Salvete omnes! Spero ut vos omnes bene habeatis. Do you remember what we talked about last time? That's right, we talked about sheep. Or, slightly more accurately, we talked about the imperfect tense endings. At the end of the last lesson, I challenged you to try to follow the steps we discussed to figure out the imperfect tense endings on your own. Okay, so let's see how that went. Remember, the first thing you had to do was find your present stem. After that was the sheep parade. And you just added the BA, ba, onto the stem for first, second, and third person, singular and plural. Ba, 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 ba. That's right. Just ba, 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 ba. Then you add the personal endings. The good old OST, mustisenti. Fantastic. But wait, if that's all you do, one of these endings looks a little weird. Just a little bit off, you know? Which one looks weird to you,
First person singular.
Wait, what was that?
First person singular.
Right. The first person singular is the one that's a little bit off. That AO combination isn't one that we see commonly in English, and you don't in Latin either. All right, now if you remembered, at the beginning of the last video, we discussed how the endings that you learned as the present tense endings form the basis of several tenses. But the first person singular personal ending, in some cases, is an M instead of an O. And the imperfect tense is one of those situations. So instead of an O after the first person singular, ba, you use an M. So the ending is bomb. Much easier to say than whatever this was. Okay, so that means the imperfect tense endings are bombaspat, bamuspatispant. And you just put these endings right onto the present stem. So that's great. But how the heck do you translate these endings? In order to figure that out, we'll have to talk a little bit more about sheep. Now, what do sheep have that most animals do not have? What was that? What?
Wool.
Yes, sheep have wool. And what letter does wool start with?
W.
Yes, okay. So for each Latin tense, you are going to use a particular English helping verb to translate it correctly. For the present tense, if you remember, you used is, am, are. For the imperfect tense, you're going to use a helping verb that begins with W, like wool. Can you think of any English helping verbs that begin with a W?
Was, were.
That's right. You use the helping verbs was and were to translate the imperfect tense in Latin. The technical definition of the imperfect tense is that it is an ongoing action happening in the past, or an action that doesn't have a fixed end point. Think about walking a dog. If you say, I walked the dog, then presumably that refers to one time when you walked the dog and then it was over. If you say, I was walking the dog, the completion of the activity is not emphasized and may not even have occurred. It is an action that happened in the past over some period of time. That's the imperfect tense. So, let's look back at our chart. Here we can see amo, amare, conjugated in the imperfect tense. With the present stem in white and the correct bam, bas, bat, bamus, bati, spant endings in orange. You would translate this verb as I was loving, you were loving, he, she, or it was loving, we were loving, you all were loving, and they were loving. How about laudo laudare? Laudabam, I was praising. Laudabas, you were praising. Laudabat, he, she, or it was praising. Laudabamus, we were praising. Laudabatis, You all were praising. Lauda bant, they were praising. Okay, great. Bonum fortunam with your practice exercises after the video, and I'll see you next time for the future tense endings. Walete!